The first step is to make the butter. Now I'm going to add about 4 tablespoons, which is 1/4 cup of coconut milk. We're sticking with our Asian vibe. And next, ice cold sparkling water. And it has to be sparkling and cold. And we're going to whisk everything in. All right, now that's about done. My wet ingredients are done. Now, next is the dry ingredients. I have some flour. I need about 2 tablespoons of it, and we need to sift it along with some corn starch or corn flour. So 2 tablespoons of that. And I'm also going to add a pinch, which is 1/4 teaspoon of bicarbonate of soda. We're sifting it in, so this is as close as I'm getting today to baking. Right, that's about done. This aside. And of course, we are making a dessert, so we need some form of sweetness. 2 tablespoons of some brown sugar. You can use normal sugar if you like. And now for taste, we're going to have a pinch of salt. Right, we're going to stir that together. Let's stir to make sure everything is well mixed. There's a few steps to this, but don't be put off because they're all very simple. Look, I'm almost done with my batter. I'm going to add my wet ingredients. And I must stir as I'm doing it. What you want is a thickness of a double cream. And in fact, it's better to whisk than to stir to make sure all the lumps are whisked in. All right, next up is to make my coating. We've got 8 tablespoons of coconut. And I know we've got coconut in the batter and we've got coconut in the coating. I just love it and it works perfectly this way. So that's the last one. And I'm going to mix it up with 4 tablespoons of corn flour, and the corn flour will give it a very nice crunch. Let us fry our bananas. I'm gonna cut it in half and then dip them in the batter. And I'm going to first coat it with the coconut mixture. Now, this is what's going to make them very nice and crunchy. Right, make sure everything is well coated. All right, now the next bit, it's very important that your oil is hot. And how you test it is we're going to take a little bit of this coconut mixture. And as soon as it sizzles, then you know it's ready. So gently and carefully dip it in. Now, I'm not one who likes to shallow fry or even deep fry stuff, but this is one of those very few exceptions because it is that good. And now these need to cook for a few minutes on each side. And I'm going to get on with the rest. They are toasted and crunchy on the outside, but still very soft in the middle, which is exactly what I want. You can also use other fruits for this, like peaches, apples, and even pineapples. All right, now I'm going to cover these in foil and put them in the oven because I want them to still be warm when I serve them up with ice cream.